Hello everyone, in this session we are going to discuss about the second subunit, that is interaction of genes, which come under the paper 6, that is genetics, biostatistics, evolution and paleontology. So we have already discussed about the Mendelian principles in the first subunit. So these interaction of genes are nothing but the continuation of the Mendelian principles. So we'll see what type of examples which it consists of. So in interaction of genes, it consists of incomplete dominance, supplementary factor, dominant epistasis, recessive epistasis, complementary factors and lethal genes. So these are the examples we need to study for the syllabus. So the definition goes like this: the expression of a single character by the interaction of more than one pair of genes, that is called as genetic interaction or interaction of genes. So here what happens, mainly it is nothing but the deviation of the Mendelian inheritance. So Bateson and Punnett, they propose the factor hypothesis to explain this genetic or the genic interactions. So according to this hypothesis, some characters or some genes, or you can tell the characters, are produced by the interaction of two or more pair of factors. So that is genes. So as they have given the factor hypothesis, so it tells some characters are produced by the interactions of two or more pair of factors. So this is how they explained the interaction of genes. So this interaction of genes, they are of two types. One is non-allelic interaction and one more is allelic interaction. So in non-allelic interaction, what happens? The genetic interaction or the genes interaction occurs between the genes located in the different locus of the same chromosome or different chromosome. Then only the genetic interaction, or that is non-allelic interaction, takes place. But whereas in allelic interaction, the genetic interaction between the two allele of a single locus, that is called as allelic interaction. So these are the two important types of genic interactions, that is non-allelic and allelic interactions. So these are the examples: the complementary genes, supplementary genes, duplicate genes, epistasis and lethal genes. These above five examples which I have noted, they come under the non-allelic gene interaction. The complete dominance, incomplete dominance, codominance, pleiotropism, penetrancy, expressivity, cumulative genes or polygenes, they come under allelic gene interaction. So in this session, mainly we'll concentrate on the first one, that is non-allelic gene interaction. So first one, that is the complementary genes. So in complementary genes, the two or more non-allelic dominant genes, they interact with one another to produce a character. So once the character is produced, then what happens? One gene cannot produce the character in the absence of the another. So that is why both the genes has to be there, then only complementary takes place. If two genes, they are of dominance, then only the complementary will be seen in the next generation. So here the ratio will be 9:7. So example is the flower color in sweet peas. So the flower color, we'll see the example, then I'll explain the theory. So in this example, usually what happens, the complementary genes, as you can see, white variety, that is capital C, capital C and capital small p is crossed with small c, capital P, capital P. Just remember these two notations, like how you can represent white variety. Now we'll see the theory behind that, why white color and red color. So now this flower color was studied by the Bateson and Punnett. So here they said the red color of the flower is due to the presence of the pigment, that is anthocyanin. And the anthocyanin is produced from a colorless substance, that is chromogen. So if the action of the enzyme has to be happened, then only this chromogen will be activated, and that leads to the formation of anthocyanin. If enzyme is not present, chromogen will not be secreted and anthocyanin, that is red color, will not be synthesized inside the flower. So now this is how the theory goes on. So now the red color of both chromogen and the enzyme should be present in plant, as I was telling that same thing. The dominant gene, that is capital C, is responsible for chromogen. And recessive gene, that is small c, is not responsible for chromogen. But here the dominant gene, that is capital A, it is responsible to convert the chromogen into anthocyanin. Thus that gives the red color. So recessive A here, it is also not responsible for the production of enzyme. So here you need to remember capital C and capital A are dominant gene which are responsible for production of chromogen and conversion of chromogen into anthocyanin respectively. Whereas recessive small c, that is small a, are responsible for, are not responsible for chromosome conversion. And also the enzyme is not important, or it cannot produce the chromogen without the conversion into anthocyanin. So here, as a gene, that is capital C dominant, it is chromogen. Gene capital A, that is enzyme. When you combine chromogen and enzyme, it gives red color, that is anthocyanin. So usually the red flower is produced by the interaction of both dominant gene, that is capital C and capital A. Here capital C and capital A cannot give red color independently. It means both the capital notation has to be present, then only red color formation takes place. So here the homozygous white flower, that is capital C, capital C, small a, small a, is crossed with the another white flower, that is small c, capital A, capital A. So when you cross these two varieties, you will get the red color or the purple color, which gives in the F1 generation, that is capital C, small c, and capital P, small p. So this is how the interaction of genes that takes place in complementary. But then what happens? Both non-allelic gene, that is capital C and capital A, are complementary. But how it takes place then? But we need to see the dihybrid ratio. So in dihybrid ratio, what happens? The dihybrid ratio, when capital C, capital P is crossed with capital C and capital P, will get capital C, capital C, capital P, capital P. So here both capital C and capital P are present. So then it will be purple. So again, this capital C, capital P is crossed with next, that is capital C, small p. So here what happens? You'll get capital C, small c, capital P and capital P. So in this also, we are having both the capital C as well as capital P, then it will be purple. Next we'll cross with the same capital C, capital P is crossed with small c, capital P. So here capital C, capital C and small c, capital P and capital P. So even in this we'll be having capital C and capital P, that denotes purple. So the last one, that is capital C, capital P, is crossed with small c and small p. So here you will get the F1 generation, same thing, because both the notations are present. Capital C, small p, and capital P and small p, both you are having. So then it will be purple because both the notations are present. So we'll see this example why it is coming white. See, here we are crossing the capital C, small p into the this one, the above capital C and small c. So as I was telling, the how we'll get the white color. So white color will be got by the interaction by using this notation, capital C, small p into capital C small p, then we'll get this interaction, that is white, because here there is no capital P, only capital C will not give the red color, that is what they are explaining. And one more we'll see, that is how the recessive, all the recessive conditions will be coming. So in recessive condition, you need to check for both these small letters, small c and small p, here that is also white in color. So when you make the checkerboard, you will get all the notations which are having in the same as dihybrid cross, 9:3:3:1. So that is same thing, but that 3:3:1 will be complemented to one another. That is how it gives 9:7 ratio in the complementary genes. So this is about the complementary genes, very important for your examination. They can ask with the different examples. So read this and study about this complementary genes properly. Next, coming to supplementary genes. So in supplementary genes, so what happens? The two dependent pair of dominant genes which interact in such a way that each dominant gene produces its effect whether the other is present or no. So it is completely opposite of complementary gene. So here what they tell, the two independent pair of dominant gene, they have to interact. So that time the dominant gene produces its effect whether the other is present or no. So even if capital C and capital P in the either condition, if it is present or no, then also the supplementation takes place. That is called as supplementary gene. So here the example is inheritance of the Combs, the fowl. So the example. So this is the example. So there are different types of Combs in the fowls, that is the interaction of two dominant genes. Here it is controlling the same characters which was discovered by the Bettison and Punnett. So there are four types of combs, those are rose comb, pea comb, walnut and single. So these are the different types of combs, like rose comb, you can see the external, how the upper side you can see the segmented structures on the comb. This is the comb. And pea comb, it is nothing but only a single segmentation, but not larger than the rose comb. Walnut is nothing but large structure, but it has not having any spike. And the last single, that is you are having spikes on the comb. So these are the four different types of combs. So here the rose comb is controlled by the dominant gene capital R. So here the example, the capital R is the rose comb and small r it comes to the pea comb again. So it is controlled by the dominant gene, that is capital P. The recessive alleles of the above genes in the homozygous condition, that is homozygous means they have to be in same thing, that is small r, small p. So if it is dominant homozygous, then it will be R, capital P. So those are brought together by the interaction. Then the walnut comb is due to the interaction of two non-allelic dominant genes, that is R and capital P. So the dominant gene has to interact. And later the single comb is due to interaction of two recessive, that is r and p. So walnut is produced by both dominant and the single comb is produced by both the recessive. So we'll see that in example. So here the same as the checkerboard, we need to check the rose comb are taken as R, small p is crossed with the a p comb, that is r, capital P. So then you will get the F1 generation as R, capital P and small p. And later in the second generation, F2 generation, the first one capital R capital P is crossed with capital R capital P. So where capital R and capital P are present, that will be walnut. So if you check this side, if you check this side, and if you check this side, so these three regions, 9 will be the walnut. But whereas in the second, that is rose, how rose? Both the recessive genes has to be present. So if you check for capital R and small p is crossed with capital R and small p. So here rose will be represented in this way. Capital R and small p, that will be rose. Here in rose, you need to see P letter should be recessive. Next one, we'll see about the P, that is here, what letter should be recessive? Here, the recessive letter should be small r or the capital, sorry, the or the letter R. So that is brought by small r capital P is crossed with small r small p. Both side the letter should be recessive of R, then only you will get the P. So in case last one, that is the single is brought by both the recessive types, that is small r and small p into small r and small p. So that time you will get the single type. Both the letters, that is letter R and letter P, are recessive in nature, then only you will get the single type. So this is about the supplementary genes. And the ratio of supplementary genes will be 9:3:3:1. So as in this, the 9 are the walnut type, that is 9. Then 3 will be the rose type, 1, 2 and 3. And later we are having the P, there are 3 P's, these are the P, and last one will be the single. So this is how the interaction of genes that takes place in the supplementary genes. And these are the 4 different types of comb, that is rose comb, pea comb, walnut and single. So this is about the supplementary genes. So next, read about this. They can ask you for 2 marks or 4 marks, the difference between complementary genes and supplementary genes. And ratio is very important. Next, we'll move on to the epistasis. So epistasis is nothing but, it is a prevention of the expression of one gene by the another non-allelic gene. So here it means stopping or inhibiting. So the genes has to stop the interaction by another non-allelic gene, then only it is called as epistasis. The inhibiting gene is called as epistatic gene, and the inhibiting gene, the non-inhibiting gene, it is hypostatic. So it has to be non-inhibiting gene. So there are of 2 types, that is dominant epistasis and recessive epistasis. So we'll see what is dominant epistasis. So dominant epistasis is nothing but the prevention of the expression of a gene by dominant non-allelic gene. So here the dominant non-allelic gene has to be with that the expression of the gene has to be prevented, then it is called as dominant epistasis. Example is white color feathers of fowl. So here the epistasis is the non-allelic interaction, and single character is controlled by the interaction of 2 or more non-allelic gene. So the same thing, 2 or more non-allelic gene, then only it is called as the epistasis. So here both the non-allelic and allelic interaction also needs to be dominant. So then only, here the example is the plumage color in leghorn. So capital C, capital C, capital I, which gives the white leghorn. is crossed with small c, small c, small I, that is polymorph rock. So we'll see the theory behind how it comes. So in white leghorn, there are white birds and colored birds both. So the colored birds are due to the presence of dominant capital C, and white color is due to presence of recessive small letter C. The bird cannot produce color pigment and the bird is white. So usually the white color will be recessive and the red color will be dominant. So now what happens? The dominant gene, that is capital C, inhibits by the another dominant gene, that is capital I. So when both dominant genes interact, their inhibition takes place. So that time inhibition, then what happens? When I is present along with capital C, the bird cannot produce any color pigmentation. Hence, the bird will be white. So if only capital C is present, then it will be red in color. But now what happens? There is one more gene, that is capital I. So that inhibits the action of capital C. Then only the color pigmentation is reduced or it is removed. You can tell the red color is brought to the white color. So it is not expressed. So here, these are the notations how different types of genes are present. So now, what is the ratio here? Ratio will be actually 13:3. So here one mistake is there. Please note it. The small c, capital C, and small I and capital I, it has to be color, not white. So that is small mistake. You change it, but I can correct here. Usually how all white color and red colored or colored usually comes. So where capital C interaction with the capital C, usually white color will be there. Capital C and capital C, if only capital C and capital C and small I and small I will be there, then it will be colored. So this is how the color notations are there. So remember, if only capital C and capital C both notations along with the small I, then it will be colored. So if it is small c and capital I and capital I, so that time also it will be white in color, because white capital I is present. So remember these two genes, how they can express capital C along with that no another dominant, then it will be colored. If the V is small, then obviously it is white, but in case capital I is present, then it will be going to white in color. So this is the example for their gene, that is the first one coming under your dominant epistasis. This is one more example, that is epistasis, or that is color coat in dog. The examples I have taken the Labradors, which are black in color, little white or yellowish, and chocolate color. So same example you can give. Usually they can ask with the different examples, so make a note on that dominant epistasis. So next, coming to recessive epistasis. So recessive epistasis is nothing but the prevention of the expression of a gene by a recessive non-allelic gene. So that is recessive epistasis. Example is color coat in mice. So here the color coat in mice is brought by capital B, small b, capital C, small c, is crossed with capital B, small b, and capital C, small c. So that time what it gives? It also gives capital B, small b, capital C, small c. So the theory behind that, the inheritance of the coat color in mice is an example for the recessive epistasis. So usually we are having three different colors, that is agouti, which is gray in color, and black, and later we are having albino, which is white in colors. So here the dominant gene M and A, it produce agouti. Black is produced by dominant gene A, And dominant A is inhibited by the recessive gene, that is small m. So here the ratio will be 9:3:4, because the last recessive 9:3:3:1, which changes in dihybrid ratio, that one A will be suppressed and it is brought to the same thing. So here the example is the color coat in mice. So in first condition, capital B and capital C, and capital B and capital C is crossed with capital B and usually here what happens, both will be producing capital B, capital C. Later again the same thing, here what happens, small b and capital C is crossed with the small b and capital C. Second one will take. So there it gives, if capital B and capital C is present, then it will be black in color. So same thing, 9 are black. If B is recessive and C is dominant, then it will be the next, that is a gouty. And both small c, that is C is recessive, then it will be white in color. So this is how the representation of recessive epistasis takes place. So next we'll see about the lethal genes. This is the last subtopic which comes under the non-allelic gene interaction. So lethal genes are the genes which kills its possessor. So here you need to study about lethal genes in man and lethal genes in mice. So in man, usually sickle cell anemia, that is the example, and the juvenile idiocy. So here what happens, the small children, the due to interaction, just read about this and how the defects takes place in the idiocy and sickle cell anemia. Already you might have known about the sickle cell anemia, but here in idiocy what happens, the defection of the kidney, lungs, everything takes place in the younger age. But whereas here in sickle cell anemia in man, the heredity blood disease. So the notations are very important, recessive genes and dominant gene, and here this is very important how we represent. So the heterozygote condition is crossed with the heterozygote, the both are sickle cell carriers, means they carry the disease. So capital S and capital A along with the HB, that is hemoglobin, you can take. So that time we will be having two are recessive, that is S and S, and two will be heterozygote, same as the parents, and one will be normal because A and A will interact. So that is normal condition. But when the recessive condition is there, that will die because of the maximum amount of sickle cell production. Last, that is lethal genes in mice. So this is also important. So here what happens, in lethal genes of mice, the dominant gene Y and dominant Y, that is the dominant gene, produces the lethal effect. And here capital Y, it represents the homozygous dominant. Capital Y and small y, it represents yellow color, that is heterozygote condition. But here when capital Y and small y is crossed with capital Y and small y, what happens? If capital Y and capital Y, so then it will be a dominant, but here recessive has to be taken. So if the dominant takes place in lethal genes, then the dominant, or sorry, the recessive gene will die. But here it is a recessive lethal gene, so the dominant will die here. So yellow color capital Y will die, and capital Y and small y, that is heterozygote condition, they are same as parent, it will survive. Small y and small y will be gray in color. So remember these two different types of genes, that is dominant and recessive. Here in sickle cell anemia, the recessive will die because of the what type? Homozygous recessive condition. So in mice, what happens? The recessive lethal allele will be expressed and it will survive, but the dominant gene, that is capital Y and capital Y, which are yellow in color, will die. So in this session, we have discussed about non-allelic interactions, that is complementary genes, supplementary genes and lethal genes. Very important. I know it is little tough to understand genetics in your online classes, but you need to study the different types of examples by making the checkerboard. So that's about this session. Thank you.